Hey everyone, Joe here. Well, today I got another quick gear review for you. Now what we have today is Ashampoo Photo Optimizer version 6. Now this is a really nice little photo editing application for, you know, entry level photographers and stuff, or people who just don't have time to use something like Lightroom and want something much easier, much simpler to use. So anyway, I think this is a great little program, but to actually review it, we need to do a hands-on demonstration. So let's hop over here to the computer and I'll show you Photo Optimizer 6.0. Okay, everyone, let's first start by looking at the user interface and everything. Now over here to our left, we have our file folders and stuff, so you can easily point the application to your files, your photos and stuff, so you can be able to edit them. Now it comes with some default photos and stuff for testing, and normally they're put in the users, you know, public folders or whatever, but I kind of moved them over here to Work Drive just, you know, for security reasons. And we can see there they are listed down here below. And really nice because you can actually select multiple files at the same time or just one individual file. And this is pretty much nice because you can make these smaller or bigger, listed over here. And over here we got a little previews, going before and after. Now obviously the both sides look the same. Let's click on the auto optimize. You can see you got the optimized photo and the original. And right here we have some easy rotating buttons, a free rotation, and also optimize all and an undo button. So let's click undo and you can see it reset it back to the default or your previous action you just recently done. We have a little drop down menu here for you can add some more tools and stuff. As you got, see you got listed here. We can add all those to the little top here. Really nice to have all those here, easy to get to. Now all these are also already in the program here over to the side, but there's little quick tools and stuff in case you want the quick tools. Okay, now when you do edit your files and stuff, you do have a file save here, so you can save your file and it saves it back in the normal location. So now let's say we have multiple files, you can click on individual files and look at them. You can move that bar over to the side if you don't want to look at it. And let's just take a look at them here. A few of them look, they've been kind of touched up. You can go up, for example, this one. If we hit auto optimize, it kind of makes it look a little bit better and stuff, which I think for just basic photos, that actually works quite well. And if you try to move to another one and ask you if you want to save it or not, just click no. Now, for example, I click auto optimize on this one. It works pretty decent. Now, over here to the side, we have some basics. We have crop, resize, watermark, a print, and of course, delete. Then we have auto corrections, you know, not auto correction, brightness and contrast, so we can adjust the brightness of the image. Got little reset buttons here. Let me pull that over into the interface. It's quite nice. Also find very nice is when you have one of the dialog boxes up, you notice everything else other than the photo is that just kind of blurred a little bit, which is quite nice. That way it keeps you focused on the tool you're actually using. So the contrast works, you know, quite well. Let's do cancel on that one. Yeah, I have hue and saturation here. You got lightness. Still think the lightness is kind of odd, but I think it's more like the color brightness. Saturation here, like any other saturation, you can overkill it, underkill it. Now hue is right here. Now hue works like, you know, any kind of white balance tool. However, there's no color temperature option. I really wish there was a color temperature option in there, but I think if you just get your camera on normal, like you know, auto white balance, most of them normally get it fairly right. So I don't really think it's a big issue with the not having in the program, but I would have liked to have seen it nonetheless. Let's go ahead and click OK. Then down here we have rotate, mirror. Of course, these work any other function. Now, one thing I do like here is the straight horizontal function. Let me pull this in. And it shows you what you can do. For example, you put one point to the wall or where you want the angle at, another other angle. And it normally does a pretty good distance. Now, there's no way to actually, you know, fix anything, like anything slanting, like wide angle lens, for example, here. There's no way to fix that. But if you got like a horizon, you can put one point on one side of the horizon another at the other point you think should be the level point, and you just click OK and it'll level your photo up, which I think is a really good feature. Then you also got, you can also do other things like, you know, free rotation. If you click that one, you can move it around any way you want. And also, which is really good for the free rotation, is you can also, you know, change, you know, the angle over here, you know, and do stuff. Like that, and y'all, you know, like that. Basically, so you can add like a photo in there, you know, do like a background and stuff. You can change the background colors in case you're trying to do like some kind of like, you know, montage of photos or anything. Let's click cancel on that. So yeah, got some rotate and mirror tools and everything. Now it does have a few little nice features here, like whiten teeth, you know, remove spots, clone area. The remove spots and clone area work fairly well. However, they're not for like big objects. For example, this this fan right here, you couldn't really remove it with it. However, for example, let's mix something easy here. Let's just remove spot like this bird over here in the corner. Boom, easily gone. You know, of course, you got like a few options here. You have the size and stuff. So click OK. Yeah, it's good removing what small spots. You know, like I said, this is ideal for face though. So if somebody's got like a face, might have like a blemish, bump, or something of that nature, works quite well. Remove the red eyes can help, you know, removing kind of flash in the red eyes or anything. Whiten teeth, that's always nice. You know, option to kind of brighten teeth and everything up. Those work kind of well. You know, not the best in the world, but they still work, you know, well enough for most people. And there's nothing wrong with them whatsoever. Then you got a few effects here, like you can make your image look older. Let me pull this dialogue in here. You know, stuff like this nature. You get your color effect. Got like those. Got image overlays. So if you want to, like, you know, a picture of your ex-girlfriend, you can show her burning or whatever. Or, you know, little daisies, the flowers, like a summer picture. Let me see. Cancel this. Let me pick out another one. Let's go to this one. Let's do an auto-optimize. Yeah. See, auto-optimize worked really well on that one. Let me see. Undo. See, kind of ball flat, dull flat. You know, like you would anything. Folder. Let me see here. Auto-optimize. Yeah. Makes it look quite nice. I do like it. Now, let's go back to that, image overlay again. Let's pull it in here. For example, like this one. Yeah. Kind of okay. Then we have here like a frame. Put a window frame. Got a few options. Overall, not too bad. Then we got an emboss feature. I don't think most people got a use for that. Some people do. You know. Window, kind of a shade thing. It's kind of moves the angle of it here. It's kind of unique if you notice what it's doing. Yeah, kind of unique there. Got a blue shift option. Let me pull this in. That's the effects and stuff. Now we got some color effects. You can go like sepia tone, grayscale, invert it if you want to. Got threshold. Threshold option works through here. Let's reset all those. Then you got like an adaptive threshold. It's more of an artistic look. Got some more artistic options down here. We have like oil painting. I want to make like an oil paint look out of one of your photos. It'll work for that. Charcoal. Doesn't really look too much like charcoal to me, but I guess it works all right. Get sketch here, like pencil sketching. And of course, make it black and white might look a little better. Make the links and those sketches longer. Yeah, okay. And got posterize, which is pretty nice about posters and stuff. It's a feature I do like. Solarize. Not sure who would want to use this, but I believe they just include it for Somebody might have use for it. I really don't. Then we have a few other things here like sharpen. You know, the strength of the sharpening and stuff that you want to use. Make it look really, really sharp. You got an adaptive sharpening. Very similar. Then you get blur effects. Might have use for that. Got a motion blur. And maybe a real heavy motion blur. And then got an adaptive blur. Yeah, I think that probably worked better on other things. Then we have some noise tools. Of course, also noise reduction, which I think is very nice. You know, let's try the adaptive noise reduction. Click on it again. It's one of those where you kind of like use it and doesn't really have any kind of tools for it. Works well enough. A few other options like spread, median. You know, cancel that one. Of course, you can also add noise if you wanted to. Got a few distort options like swirl. Work on that if you really wanted to. Creating a flower black hole. Implode, explode. Really help with that duct face everybody's been working on. You know, a few options, all that. Then you have lots of export. You get an option to help mail stuff out. An Ashampoo web upload. Can't show you that feature without getting the actual paid version. Then you got like a wallpaper option. Click and set your wallpaper and stuff to your computer and everything. But overall, it's not too bad. I think for a program that's under $10, this could be something that for somebody who just likes to take photos but doesn't really do much with them other than to share them on Facebook but wants to be able to do a few adjustments and stuff, this could be really great for them. And also have like a built-in organizer and stuff so you can look at your photos, decide which ones you want to edit, delete, share. You know, it can be really great for that. Like I said, for under $10, I think it's a pretty decent program overall. Now, it's not for anybody who's like an advanced amateur or professional photographer, obviously. But I think for like a home user just likes to go out, take travel photos, just kind of tweak them a little bit, share them on Facebook, Instagram, things like that nature. I think it's going to be a really, really good program for that. If you like this video, then you may also like Ashampoo Photo Recovery. Photo Recovery recovers deleted or corrupted image files. You can even recover your photos from damaged RAW files or formatted disk. Learn more by clicking the link in the description below. Okay, everyone. Well, like I said, I think this is a pretty decent little program, but it's meant for novices and entry-level photographers and not really meant for professionals. Now, that said, I think it's a great application for something that costs under $10. And like I said, for that price range, if you're not looking for something like Lightroom, you want something more simple, more basic, just something to really organize your photos and kind of do minor tweaks and stuff, well, this could be a great program for that. So anyway, do check it out. Links for it will be listed down in the description below. And anyway, if you like this review and you found it helpful, so how about giving me a thumbs up? Thumbs up's always highly appreciated. And if you're not a subscriber to my channel yet, go ahead and take time to subscribe. Subscribing is free. It's for you. I'll let you know when I release more videos. And while you're at it, also check out my Amazon store. Links for it's down in the description below, as well as my Spreadshirt store where I'm constantly uploading new photo artwork and stuff for great t-shirt designs. And my name's Joe, and I hope to see you in the next video.